Riding the wave of a three-game winning streak, the Avalanche continue their long homestand with a tilt against the Blue Jackets at Pepsi Center. The Avs are 3 points out of the playoffs, while the Jackets are currently in a spot in the East. From Lodo, it's Colorado hosting Columbus on altitude. Hi, I'm Mike Haynes along with Peter McNabb. And Peter, boy, has it been fun at Pepsi Center lately. The last three games for the Avalanche, not only winning the games, but it's been the fashion in which they have won those games.
Mike, you and I, we both love a little drama inside of a game. And
bring in Mike Haynes, standing by with the hero from Tuesday night, Eric Johnson.
All right, thanks very much, Kyle. Eric, you have scored some big goals in your career, but you got to tell me how much fun that was when you scored an overtime winner as a defenseman on a breakaway. What was it like? How did it happen?
Yeah, it was fun, Mike. I mean, I don't get too many breakaways, but 3-on-3, anything can happen, and it was fun to be able to end the game that way, and hopefully we can continue this winning streak we're on.
It is a great winning streak, and you've been winning it in thrilling fashion. Now you're playing a team you haven't seen this year. Tell me about the game plan against Columbus.
Yeah, I think we're pretty familiar with them just because Jared and Nolan coaching the organization, so they're familiar with what they're all about, and you know, there's no easy games. Every game's a challenge, so tonight will be no different.
Tell me about the defensive core now. Missing Tyson Barrie, and you're getting in there playing your normal amount of minutes. Has anything changed? What are you guys trying to do as a defensive core right now?
Yeah, I think you've seen Sammy step up a little bit, get a little bit more minutes. He's been good on the power play, and me and no different. Try and play the same way I've been playing, and everyone needs to pick up the slack. Tyson's a great offensive defenseman, and we miss him back here, but so far, so good.
So far, so good. Great goal. So much fun the other night. Keep it going. Have a great game tonight.
Thank you, Mike.
All right. There he is, the Condor, Eric Johnson. Now back to you. Kyle, take it away. With 2017 coming to an end and the second half of the season around the corner, the Avs' resolution is to stay in the playoff race. And tonight at Pepsi Center, the Islanders are in town for what could be a high-scoring contest. On New Year's Eve, Altitude presents Colorado against New York. Hi, everybody. Mike Haynes, Mark Rycroft, and Happy New Year to everybody. Well, Mikko Rantanen, right now going to the last game of 2017, is riding an 8-game point streak. Mark, it's certainly a remarkable accomplishment, but how is he doing this? Why is he playing so well?
Well, one, playing with Nathan MacKinnon always helps, but two, he's finally starting to, and it's showing, but having Nathan MacKinnon right there, boy, they're feeding off each other. Landeskog doing the final touches on that line.
Yeah, that's a great line that's going right now. Rantanen, one of the beneficiaries of it, in an 8-game point streak going into tonight's game against the New York Islanders. Let's find out more about tonight's game and the goaltending matchup. We send it back to John Michael and Kyle.
Okay, guys, appreciate it very much. Yeah, eight.
Here's why I feel optimistic as well. You go between the crease and you look at Semyon Varlamov and especially his health. You go back to 2013-14 season when he was a Vezina Trophy candidate, and here was a guy who was healthy all season, was clearly MVP for the Avalanche and maybe in the National Hockey League that season. Well, he had his surgery in the offseason. He is healthy. And watching him during those preseason games, he looks like he is ready to play. He's hungry. He has something to prove. He looks great. He looks comfortable. And when he is playing the way that he plays, not only can you help the team win just simply by your play, but also it's an example, Peter, but the other players just seem to sort of lift their games because they know that Varlamov is back there. And if anything happens, he can make that big save to help you win. So that's why I'm optimistic, Kyle and Mark, about what the Avalanche can do this season.
A new season brings on a new optimism. Your thoughts on tonight's matchup with the New York Rangers?
You know, Kyle, thank you so much. You know, I love the first game of the season because everybody feels like maybe if everything goes right, we can win. We can get a championship. We can haul around the cup on the ice at the end of this season. So you feel optimistic. Peter, tell me why you feel optimistic about the Avalanche this season.
Because I really do like the core players for this Avalanche club.
But certainly we know that he's maybe the smartest guy in the National Hockey League, and that's Alexander Kerfoot.
You know what? It has been such a pleasure to watch him play during training camp. You don't know what he's going to be like. He comes in after 4 years of playing at Harvard, where last year he was one of the co-captains, had a great season, over 40 points in 36 games playing for the Crimson. And here's a player who's not that big, 5'10", 160 pounds, but clearly smart off the ice, and he is smart on the ice. The coaches love his vision. Now here's a guy a little bit older than a normal rookie coming in the league. He's 23 years of age, but boy, he carries himself well. He holds the puck. He sees the ice real well. He is a real addition to this team. Where is he going to play in terms of long term? Is he going to be a centerman? Is he going to be a winger? He's a guy really that makes great passes, can see the ice. Maybe the long term is at center, but the future is bright for Alexander Kerfoot. Couple of things real quick. First of all, he said his mom wants to make sure that everybody calls him Alexander. That's what he was named. The other thing is, you know what? After 22 years of having conversations with Peter, it's so nice now to finally have someone that I can have intellectual conversations with Alexander Kerfoot.
I thought it was going to take longer for you to use that line, but straight out of the gate. I'm sure we'll hear that during the broadcast, but good on you, Mike. We appreciate it. All right. Back to MSG, down on the ice, Mike Haynes, Nathan MacKinnon.
Thanks very much, Kyle. Well, Nathan, you're going into your fifth season of the National Hockey League. Tell me, what do you need to do for yourself and for the team to be successful this season?
I think just stay even keel. You know, last year we had some downs and we rode those, and we're going to have some highs this year. We need to stay even keel, and that's what I've learned through my first four seasons, that it's a roller coaster and you have to enjoy it. And it's exciting. We have a lot of young guys, and they're going to really have a lot of fun this season.
You always hear how important it is to have a good start, but coming off of last season, how important is it for the Avalanche team to have a good beginning to this season starting tonight?
It's important. You know, we want to get off to a good start. You know, we always want to trust the process, and you know, we're not gonna think about wins. We're gonna focus on, you know, having good periods, and hopefully that translates into that. But like I said, it's 82 games. You know, we don't have to win the first 10 to have a good season. So hopefully we can have a good start tonight and keep it going from there.
All right, you're one of the leaders on the team. Have a great game tonight and a great season. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. Appreciate it, man.
There he is, Nathan MacKinnon. Let's send it now back. Here's Kyle.
Center as it is, girls' night hockey in Colorado. Mike Haynes and his daughter, Kiara. I know she's an absolute stud when it comes to hockey, Mike, and I know you're a big part of it.
Well, I had nothing to do with her being as great a player as she is, but she is a terrific player. She's on the top team in Colorado, the 19 AAA team, Team Colorado, that's supported by the Avalanche. And Kiara, while you're at the top of your game right now, the number one team in Colorado, you've been playing hockey a long time. And what would you tell a young girl who's watching tonight and thinking, I want to play hockey? What makes girls hockey so special and why they should play?
They should absolutely play because it's a sport that you can just fall in love with and find yourself in. I mean, I've been able to develop myself as who I am as a person and me as a player. It's just something that you end up falling in love with and creating a family out of with the teammates, and it's just something you absolutely have to try.
Now, when you think about girls hockey versus boys hockey, people don't realize you're not out there with pink skates and tutus on. It can be a physical game. Tell me about how tough sometimes girls hockey can be.
I think it's tougher than boys hockey. We play dirtier than boys hockey because we have more rules to get around. I mean, when I take face-offs, I get in there and I take my shots at girls' cages without the refs looking. We have more rules and we have more that we need to kind of fight against the stereotype, I think we play dirtier than boys, for sure.
What is your favorite moment you've ever had? You've been playing hockey since you've been real little, since I had to carry you around the ice when you learned. What's your all-time favorite moment playing girls hockey?
I think my very first goal has to be my favorite moment. It has to be a favorite moment for anyone. I remember shooting the puck, and it went in the goalie's five hole, and I got to do Ian LaPerriere's signature goal scoring dance. And because he's the inspiration behind me playing hockey, and so being able to do that for my very first goal was something special.
I remember that one very, very well. And one last thing before we say goodbye, when are you going to clean the room?
Never.
Okay. All right, Kyle, for the first time ever on Altitude, we've got a good-looking Haynes with nice hair.
Yes.
Yes, Mike.
Hey, if it doesn't work for her in hockey, she can be a broadcaster and take your spot any
day.
That's it,
buddy. All right.